Adding salt to food can take years off your life. This is News Review from BBC Learning English. I'm Neil.
And I'm Beth.
And we have lots of language about this story in today's programme.
We do. And remember, subscribe to our channel, like this video, and try the quiz on our website. Now, today's story. Salt. It makes everything taste better. But it's also killing people. New research has found that adding salt to your meal may reduce your life by 2 years. But the good news is that even a small reduction in salt can make a big difference to your health.
You've been looking at the headlines, Beth. What's the vocabulary?
We have deadly, knock off, and tea time.
This is News Review from BBC Learning English. Let's have a look now at our first headline.
This one comes from US News. Your salt shaker may prove deadly, study finds.
So the word we are looking at is deadly, and Beth, there's a big clue in the first part of that word, dead.
Yeah, we see in this headline that the salt shaker, that's the thing you pour salt onto your food with, may be deadly. Now that's an adjective and it just means likely to kill.
Yeah, and we see this word often in connection with substances, diseases, dangerous situations and animals, isn't that right?
Yeah, so for example, a deadly spider is one that can kill you.
But like so many of the words we look at in News Review, it has another very different meaning, and I'm deadly serious about that.
There we go, Neil. Yeah, deadly, as you've used it there, means completely, and we often use it with dull, boring, and serious. Deadly dull, deadly boring, deadly serious. You do look a bit serious there, Neil.
Sorry, I was just thinking about that deadly spider. And get ready for the bonus word now, Beth. Spiders are dead scary.
They are, you are dead right, Neil. So some people use dead in this way too, especially if they're from the north of England, and it can mean completely or very. Dead right, dead easy, dead interesting.
Yes, and what's really interesting or dead interesting about this use is that we use it for good things, so dead easy.
Yeah, or dead good. But we don't say deadly easy or deadly good. Best to keep deadly for dull, boring, or serious things.
Let's take another look at that. Let's have a look at our next headline.
This one is from Nine News in Australia. Sprinkle of salt at table could knock 2 years off your life, study finds.
Yeah, we're looking at the phrasal verb knock off. And it's a phrasal verb, so unfortunately, it's got lots of different meanings.
Yeah, you're right. But in this headline, it just means reduce. Let's think literally. Imagine you have a pile of things, say books, and you knock one off the top. That happens.
Yeah, and so the size of the pile is smaller, it's reduced.
Exactly. So in this headline, we see that too much salt can knock years off your life. It can reduce the number of years you live.
That doesn't sound too good. We can also knock a few pounds off the price of something. So, for example, if I'm selling this beautiful luxury watch, and you think it's too expensive.
That's right. Can you knock £10 off it? I want him to reduce the price.
I'll think about it. Talking of selling watches, it's got another meaning, hasn't it?
Yeah, we can also use knock off as a single word with or without a hyphen. And this time it means a cheap, possibly illegal copy of a real product. So actually, Neil, I don't think I want that watch. It's a knockoff.
How dare you? Let's have another look at that. Our next headline then, please.
This one comes from The Sun. Teatime killer. Popular condiment increases your risk of dying young by 28%, scientists warn.
We're looking at tea time. This is easy enough. It's the time when you have tea. Everybody knows what tea is, but you don't put salt in it.
Well, that depends, Neil. Tea is, of course, a drink, and you definitely don't want to put salt in it. But tea is also a meal. Tea time is traditionally a small meal in the afternoon with tea and cake.
Yes, but there is more to tea, and this is where it can get quite confusing, because depending on where you live, tea means different things. Beth, you are from the north of England.
I am, and I call the meal that I have in the evening my main meal, tea. So I would say, do you want to come round for tea? Neil, you're from the south of England, aren't you?
Yes, I'm from the south, and I call my main meal in the evening dinner, and I would ask somebody if they want to come for dinner.
So tea time can be an afternoon meal or an evening meal, though not everyone uses tea time in this way.
Let's take a look at that one more time. We've had deadly, it can kill you.
Knock off, reduce.
And tea time, a meal for some in the afternoon or the evening.
Don't forget, there's a quiz on our website.
Thank you for joining us and see you next time. Goodbye.
Bye.